So, as the third experiment, we are going to understand the utility of a basic building block made out of the op-amp, okay, which is called an integrator, or actually another one called differentiator. We have to find out which is superior in its application for building filters. Filters are essentially blocks which are improving the signal to noise ratio, so that you can further process the signal, okay, with the least effect from the noise. And such filters are built, are nothing but differential equations solved, essentially. And these differential equations can be either solved by using integrator as the building block or the differentiator as the building block. So we'll investigate which is superior in practice, either this or that. This is the integrator block. When Vi is applied, the current injected into the op amp is Vi by R to its virtual ground, because this is held at zero, this also is very nearly zero. So the current in this is Vi by R, and that current is charging the capacitor and developing a voltage here, which is Vi by R into 1 over SC, and it is positive with respect and negative with respect to the ground. This is at 0 volts. So we have minus Vi by SCR as the output voltage. Here the R and C are interchanged, then the operation gets interchanged. Vi is driving a current in this, is which is Vi into SC, and that current flows through this R and develops a voltage which is minus SCR into Vi, and therefore it is differentiated. So now, because of the finite gain bandwidth product, these blocks are going to have their behavior changed, and that study is very important in deciding which building block is superior. And when we do that, it is the same thing, minus 1 by SCR divided 1 plus 1 over GL is the actual transfer function of the system. And if you substitute GL, which is the loop gain, which is gain of the op-amp, which is GB by S into SCR by 1 plus SCR. This is going to act in a loop like a high-pass filter whose transfer function is this. And if you introduce this in this, you will see that this integration is having an error, and the magnitude error is controlled by this GB into CR, which is fixed. And the phase error is directly proportional to the frequency of the input signal. Okay, and it is a phase lag error, okay, which is omega by GB. And therefore, the phase error keeps on increasing as frequency increases. So instead of giving you the 90 degree phase shift, there will be a further lag of omega by GB approximately, okay, for this. This you are going to study by obtaining the frequency plot of the integrator, its gain. There is one limitation, however. If it is used like this, a standalone integrator has a problem, because there is no DC feedback, okay. There is this offset, which is typically in the case of op-amps about few millivolts, okay, is going to be amplified by the DC gain, which is thousands or maybe hundreds of thousands, and therefore op-amp output is invariably in saturation, okay. So in order to bring it out of saturation, you might have to put a high resistance in feedback, which will make it do not exactly the integration. It will be non-ideal integration. Again, the phase error is going to come into picture. So however, this particular differentiator, on the other hand, has DC feedback, and therefore automatically the output is going to stay at input offset, okay, which is very small. And you can therefore apply it. However, this has a disadvantage. As you see here, the transfer function now changes from minus SCR, which is the ideal, to a second order denominator, which is always